discussing how Bengal's Dalit movement was badly ruptured at partition. It was very powerful, the most powerful movement in India before partition, 1947. But the Namashudras, who formed part of this vigorous movement, they were split by partition and remained in East Pakistan. The caste question then became a refugee displacement question for everybody. Then after the Left Front got power in 1977, it emphasized class and not caste, that the problem was poverty. And once you mitigated poverty, caste too would be irrelevant. Of course, that has not happened, and poverty has not been mitigated that much either. In this contest, when we look at what Kolani Thakur Charal has done on her own without much support, being a Dalit woman writer or a Dalit lekhika, as we say in Bengal, it's a tremendous achievement. And she will tell you now how she started as a student with a wallpaper, a little bit about her background and her publishing activities, all tremendous individual struggle without much support, and certainly not finding the existing publishers to be encouraging at all.
Actually, when I started these magazines, I was a boarder of an working girls hostel. It was in 1994-5 at that period. After that, I tried to decide to publish it in a printed form. And I published magazines, some special issues like folklore or folk drama, aborigines languages, short stories and its translation. Another issues, psychological issues, loneliness, after that disaster, after that special issue, water crisis is arising, after that reservation is another issue. Then some writings of Dalit women writings, women poetries, another issue is All India Dalit women writings, that is the Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Gujarati and Marathi and Bengali women writings, and I translated these all writings from English by some Bengali peoples and published it in Bengali and tried to I actually tried to intervene the Dalit Bengali women people and peoples, or what the Dalit others women of other states are doing in their writings now.
What is interesting is that this journal, which she's been taking care of and publishing regularly, she funds it herself, all the labor is hers, and it's called Neer, which means nest, and that has a reflection of displacement, of not having a proper shelter, that kind of thing.
And because of these magazines, I can apply it for a table in the for the book fair, where I displayed all the books of us and sell those books there. Actually, there is no place to distribute and circulate these books. We have a short shop in College Street Market, which one is on the name of Chaturtho Duniya, the journal of Bangla Dalit Sahitya Samastha. And Bangla Dalit Sahitya Samastha supported a large number of, and they make a large number of Dalit writers, the platform where we have come here. And
if I may say something about the
Bangla Dalit Sahitya Samastha, formed in 1992, and they inspired when a Shabar girl of Vidyasagar University committed suicide, humiliating by her professors, caste hegemony, and he was humiliated. Most of the writers of Bangla Dalit Sahitya Samastha come from Namashudras, Pondokhotriyo, Rajbanshi, Bauri and others. Before this, we can say Bangla Dalit Sahitya movement started from Motua literature, and it comes to our notice from the biography of Horichand Thakur and his son Guruchand Thakur. Horichand Thakur, the book Sri Sri Harilalamrita is written by Sri Tarok Chandra Sarkar, and we know the socio-economic condition of 19th century, how the downtrodden people were there in undivided Bengal, basically in the Namashudras, and their social upliftment. Guruchand Thakur tried, the son of Horichand Thakur. Horichand Thakur born in 1812, and his son was in 1846. Then Guruchand Thakur is the biography of Guruchand Thakur is written by Mohananda Haldar, and it is Guruchand Charit. It is the book. We can see there the they says against Brahminical systems. They tried. Guruchand Thakur also revolt against Brahminical systems and fight for self respect. And he encourages the people for education, and he founded schools, so many schools, with the help of Australian missionary C.S. Mead. And then he also encourages women also, and he found a school of vocational school at the name of her wife, Sottobama Balika Vidyalaya. So when Phule started his work in Maharashtra, at that period Guruchand Thakur and Horichand Thakur started the movement of upper caste upliftment in Bengal. But there is no history, mainstream history denied, or they do not mention this anywhere except these two books.
If I may interrupt, the Mathua religion, which was formed by Harichand Thakur and Guruchand Thakur, was very unusual at that time, say in the mid 19th century. It was this worldly, it was material, and he was telling the Navashudras, you will prosper with social reform, with hard work, get educated, do as much as you can trading, uplift yourself, and don't worry too much about spiritualism. So it was an attempt to help them move on, and his alliance with that missionary Kolanidhi mentions, C.S. Mead, was to, you know, take advantage of what he saw as modern ideas coming out of the missionary. So although the missionary actually also hoped that the Mathuas would convert to Christianity, they didn't, but they were able to use his suggestions, his just ways of organizing things in a modern way, and with his help they made contact with the British government, and they started to get jobs. They started, I think that she mentioned, I don't know if you were there then, but she mentioned how from in 1871 there was a massive protest, the first strike, if you like, against casteist rule, which went on for over a month. They just didn't do any of their traditional services until the upper castes had to buckle a bit. Then another thing that I think Guruchand did, which was remarkable, was to change the abusive name that had been placed on them. They were called Chandas, and she will tell you what happened.
Actually, in 1911 census report, Guruchand Thakur protested that the name of these communities registered as Chandal. Guruchand Thakur says, no, they are Namashudras. And they came to agitation, and then they appeal for change the name. And it is recognized that is they are Namashudras. But when my parents or my other relatives came to India after division, they changed their surname. They write Thakur, which is the surname of upper caste people. I think they tried to take this veil because of caste hegemony, and they tried to protect them for upper caste pressure. Kolani Thakur Chandal, because this was word is abusing word, yeah. Charal, but they I actually used, because when I was humiliated by some people in my office, and then I think as I am educated and empowered, but they do not recognize me and they treat me like so. So I use this word because I have come to so many questions. What type of your thakur you are? Are you taker?
To be in a common situation, the upper caste and the Dalits and the OBCs. Now, the thing is, another factor was that caste which could have raised his head as the middle class OBCs elsewhere in India, they were mostly Muslims. And it took on a kind of communal air before partition. So there too, caste was suppressed. And after partition, with this refugee business, it is not at all true that caste did not matter with refugee settlement. It most certainly did, because as Kolani told you, or in one of her writings she has, that the Dalit refugees who came later, the Navashudras, these were the ones who went to the camps. The upper caste, however miserable and standing in Shiada station with one Dalit set of clothing and nothing else, had some kind of connection in the cities or bits of West Bengal, some relative who would take in these 15 others and somehow they would manage. It was hardship, it was terrible. I should know, my father is from that side and our family did come over. But for the Dalits, it was terrible. The upper castes had that intellectual capital and could land on their feet somewhere a bit later. The Dalits were the ones who were sent to Dandakaranya, far away from West Bengal, into a dry area in middle Madhya Pradesh, or where, you know, these are people who were from a delta, the Marichapi. That is where the Dalits were also sent. So when the Congress governments ended and the left front, the communists came in, the communist-dominated front came in, this kind of thing continued because the refugee was mobilized for votes. Jogen Mondal, who came back and tried to re-enter politics, well, his vote banks were used, but he was kept out of a political position. He was never made a minister. This later on in the left front government, I think there were some electoral success of Dalits, but they were generally not main ministers, or if they were, they had to conform to the upper caste idea. I think this is mentioned by some Dalit writers. It is only now, when the new Trinamool has come in, which popularly is known as the end of Bhadralok culture, the end of upper caste educated culture, now an age of A Bhadralok, they have had more openings. And in fact, the Motua group, which is very powerful, they have had two elected people. You could talk about that.
Actually, Bengal is divided. She said, Dalits are powerful before division. Actually, the country was divided because of that. As the Dalits are powerful there, and they try to divide the country and dominate them at that way.
She's saying that's one of the impetus behind the partition of West Bengal, that the upper castes were quite happy.
If it was undivided, then the Dalit people would come to the power at that period. And all Muslims and Dalits collaboratively come to the power. So they tried to divide the country. It is now the Mathuas are the election factor of Bengal. And before this government, our chief minister said the word, and it was quote unquote, Abhi Motua Hobo, I will be Motua. She said it and it was published in various newspapers by quoting Abhi Motua Hobo. So, it is the next generation of Gurujan's Thakur do not follow his ideologies. So the result is this, because second highly populated Dalit state is Bengal after UP, but there is no leading person proper, and the full people is go to the to follow the main upper caste political parties, and they hijack their movement sometimes. Because I was participant of Citizenship Amendment Act 2003, there was a hunger strike in Thakurbadi at Thakur Nagar, and it was in 2004 the bill came, and we tried to oppose that bill, that Citizenship Amendment against the Citizenship Amendment Act. 2003.
This is because of the so-called immigrants from Bangladesh. But generally, I think there will be a change, because the communists are very, very weak now in Bengal. And so these Dalit parties, then the parties, party by a Muslim former communist leader who was expelled from the party, Abdul Razak Mulla Razak, he has also a group coming up, so things are in turmoil, and they will change. About historians, there's always a time lag, I think, but I know Doipayan Sen, who's at Chicago, did critique the subaltern ideology of Partha Chatterjee and Dipesh, and he said that one of the weaknesses was, or was it that they didn't actually do field work, so they didn't actually come across Dalits. And Gayatri Spivak already made that amazing statement, can the subaltern speak? So they have been rather blinded, and perhaps by their caste position. I mean, their ancestors were the great Tol Pandits, and the new ones may be the subalterns.
If I could just add one thing to the Ramashudra history has been done.
I know.
Yeah, sure. Not by the subalterns. Yes.
Well, that also has been critiqued by the Dalits.
Dalits, and now also by other...
they don't take it.
Yeah,
by Blanche, whatever you
say. Basic work.
Basic work was done by Dalits.
मेरा सवाल नहीं इनको सुनते हुए कि एक पीरियड है जब चंडाल कहा जा रहा है, तो कुछ महापुरुष आए हैं, तो उन्होंने कहा नहीं यार, ये आप लोग नफरत से कहते हैं, चंडाल नहीं है, नमो रहा। तो मैं देख रहा, और उसके बाद ये आगे कल्याणी जी आगे, तो वो कहते नहीं 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 हम चंडाल हैं, अब हम कहते हैं कि हम चंडाल हैं, आप लोग बताएंगे चंडाल क्या होते हैं। ये राइटर्स आए, उन्होंने कहा और लिख दिया, चंडाल लिख दिया अपने नाम के साथ। मैं देख रहा हूँ पंजाब में भी ऐसा ही हो रहा है, चूड़े चमार कहा जा रहा है, चूड़े चमार कहा जा रहा है। तो 1920-25 में आधर्म मंडल मूवमेंट आती है, तो बुजुर्ग कहते हैं नहीं चूड़े चमार मत कहो यार, इन्हें आदि धर्मी कहो, इनका धर्म जो है वो आदि धर्मी, तो सेंसेक्स में भी आदि धर्मी होता है। 1925 में मूवमेंट उठती है, और 1931 की सेंसेक्स में मोर देन 5 लाख पीपल अपना धर्म आदि धर्म लिखाते हैं, और उनकी आदि बढ़ाते हैं। और फिर आपकी जनरेशन मेरी जनरेशन आती है, तो कहते हैं नहीं 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 आदि धर्म छोड़ दिया, हम चूड़ा लिखेंगे, हम चुमार लिखेंगे। ये दोनों तरफ एक साइकोलॉजिकल स्टडी है, एक लड़ाई की सर्विस किया, लेकिन बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग बात लगी थी। उधर भी लड़ाई वैसी चल रही है, और टाइम के साथ इधर भी लड़ाई चल
रही है। The surname of Thakur is not our surname. When my fathers migrated from Bangladesh, yeah, East Pakistan, they take our all relatives take the surname Thakur, because they try to take this veil that upper caste people could not identify, recognize me. Who am I?
Yeah.
I think. I have come to so many questions, which type of Thakur you are? Are you Tagore? But I am coming from that city of a lot of Nobel laureate.
Thakur was attached to Sri Guru Chand because he was like a leader, a religious leader.
Yeah.
एक और ये इसी तरह के मतलब इससे थोड़ा अलग भी डेवलपमेंट हुआ है वो एक तरफ तो ये क्लेम हो रहा है जैसे चमारा दत्त उत्तर गाड़ियों में भी लिखा जा रहा है दूसरी तरफ फिर मैं महाराष्ट्र की तरफ ले जा रहा हूँ कि बहुत ही अग्रेसिव मूवमेंट था पैंथर मूवमेंट और दलित शब्द के साथ एक पूरे एग्रेशन के साथ एस्टेब्लिश किया और गर्व के साथ एस्टेब्लिश किया लेकिन अब थोड़ा वो उधर दूसरे चले जा रहे हैं हमारे कई मित्र हैं जो अब दलित शब्द पे आपत्ति कर रहे हैं और वो अम्बेडकरवादी कहा जाना पसंद कर रहे हैं और वो दलित के साथ जो डिप्रेस्ड और इसका जो जुड़ा हुआ मसला है जिसको लेकर के तो ये भी चीजें आ रही है दलित फेमिनिज्म में घटना है तो अब दलित लिटरेचर का क्या करें एक पीरियड था अभी भी दलित लिटरेचर लिखा जा रहा है दलित फेमिनिस्ट लिटरेचर का क्या करें दलित फेमिनिस्ट टर्म का क्या करें तो ये अभी एक फ्यूजन का एरिया का समय है वैसे अम्बेडकरवादी ज्यादा इंक्लूसिव टर्म मुझे भी लगता है
Very briefly, they are talking about the trend today of asserting that old Dalit name. So she's very proud of saying she's a Chara, and they're not trying to evade that. It's come up with him also. He's talking about this.
Shikitarani also says in his poetry, they are Parachi. Parachi is abuse word. She is writing in her poetry, I am Parachi.
Very enlightening and very fruitful. And our thanks to Tapan Basu and Raj Kumar also, because I think this kind of a networking among Dalit scholars from the English department, it's usually from sociology or history. But in English department, I think we need to meet and talk and discuss to get a common networking amongst us. So this has been very, very helpful for all of us. Our panel today is called Perceptions of the Dalit in Bengal and Ideology of Caste or Class. Now, on the face of it, this may be only appear to be only tangentially related to the theme of our conference, publishing and disseminating Dalit literature. But what we are going to do is we are going to try to trace through our presentations and conferences, their presentations and conversations, the politics in Dalit publishing. And it is this politics, as we've been discussing in many different ways from yesterday, is what decides what gets translated, what gets selected, how it is positioned, what is accepted as politically correct, and who's snubbed as politically incorrect. So all these questions depend upon this. So it is through this idea of the ideology that we will try to move into the area of publishing. Now, with the very long history of communism that we have had in Bengal, caste has repeatedly been interpreted as class. It's not that this has not worked. It has worked very well for quite a few decades. However, increasingly, we find that the issue of caste is being raised by some of those very people who had once believed in the ideology of class. Questions were raised by Tapan Basu in the earlier panel itself about how the subaltern historians could have remained blind to this huge area, which Mundra Sen Kalyani and Sanjeev answered. It is from there that we are taking off. So today on our panel, I have with me two people like that who had once believed in the ideology of class. I don't know if they still don't believe or don't believe. It is up to you to find that out. But on my right, far right, I have Ananta Chachu. Ananta Chachu is publisher and editor of the journal Chetana Logon, Wave of Consciousness. He is director of the Democratic Action Forum of Dalits, Women's and Minorities, which he calls the Forum. It is an organization that works towards bringing about equality and justice in Indian society. And the publication of the Forum, which publishes writings by Dalits, women, religious minorities. The writings include both creative and non-fiction writings, which deal with subjects related to Marxism and Indian nationalism. The writings are on movements of protest, inequity, exploitation, inequality, caste, class, gender, and minority. Monoranjan Bapari on my right is the writer who is now known in Bengal as the miracle man, the rickshaw puller who became writer, and these tags. To give a very, very short his biography in very brief, which is criminal because he has a fascinating life. Monoranjan Bapari's family crossed across the border with him around 1951-52. They remained for about 9 years in different refugee camps, and finally they were asked to go to Dondukarunno, something which his family refused, so they came to Calcutta. When he was about 14 or 15 years of age, Monoranjan Bapari was driven out of his home by hunger. He could not bear the hunger and he ran away from home. When there was this Naxalite movement which was going on, he got drawn into the Naxalite movement, into the violence of it, and got thrown into jail. It is in jail that he picked up letters. A co-inmate taught him and he learnt letters, came out, was working as a rickshaw puller when, with a strange turn of events, he got drawn into the world of crime. Monoranjan Bapari has won the Bangla Academy Purushkar for, has been in the vanguard of the Dalit movement in Bengal even today. So they organized a strike against the discrimination and arrogance practiced by the upper caste. By the 30s and 40s, they were into the nationalist movement, about which we spoke about in the earlier panel. They decided to stay back there, therefore, consequent violence forced them across the border. Therefore, they were latecomers, sent off to very different places, culturally, geographically alien to them. Dondukarunno was one to which Monoranjan Bapari's family was asked to go. Andaman was another one. Some of them marched from Calcutta, Barasa, to Sundarbans to lay claim to the land which they had been promised for long by the politicians. The caste Hindus still, and sincerely, I mean, it is not just a cynical idea, but some of them sincerely believe that we don't see it over here. Now, why don't they see it? One reason, of course, is that a number of sects and cults have challenged the harsher strictures of the caste system, the Vaishnav movement. The Sufi movement have been very, very strong, and Kulen spoke of the Mudhwaka, that was one of the foremost cults among these. Which, towards the latter part of it, we had the Hindu Reformation, Ramon and everybody, and so it seems to be difficult, possibly that's what happened with the subaltern groups also, it seems to be difficult for them to realize that in spite of all this, the caste system was not really addressed. They don't seem able to acknowledge that. They have deluded themselves into thinking that it has been solved. Another reason, possibly, I think, is that in post-partition India, the Dalits of Bengal have remained largely invisible because they've been scattered, because they've remained in the background. So this is something like the situation in which the Bengali Muslims were in the 19th century. In 1871, when we had our first census, and Bengal was found to be a Muslim-majority country, everybody was surprised that the Dalits have entered the workplace, schools, colleges with the right to education, and they are now beginning to become visible, and the caste question therefore has been forced to the fore. So with that, I will begin with a question to Monoranjan. No, I think I will ask Anantha Acharya to make his presentation first.
Let me admit first that I am not a good seminarist, and sometimes I won't be able to assemble proper words. I was asked to deliver, although I have submitted the paper, the question to me that why Dalit in Bengal? There is no chance of the victory of caste struggle in whatever form. Besides taking program of rights of the women and minorities, religious or religious minorities. Dapodam is in the area of publication of books on concerned subjects in different languages without support from any foreign governments, or fund. In our magazine, Chetana Labo, we printed six photos of six teachers or teachers according to age. Karl Marx, Jyotiba Phule, Rokia, Periya, B.R. Ambedkar, Bhagat. There is a notion all over India that caste doesn't touch Bengal. And Bengalis pretend to be proud of that. Very, as the court said, according to, there is the last Sunday's magazine, the popular daily, better to say, in Bengali and in English, it's a matrimonial page. I think that will be a relief to you. WB caste score 25, good looking, fair skin qualified, say girl, seeking suitable, professionally qualified. EB, CVT, Birati, Shakbiho, Pita, Pensangogi, etc. etc. Pushimo, Purvongo Kaisto, Shokalimno, government employee, Delhi settled MS in type 7 year, Kolkata Fair Kaisto 6, etc. etc. Even in English, the same like that. This is the matrimonial page, 22 page. Other ads are also there. If full page is the matrimonial page. You will get the Sudra, Vaishya, No Sudra, Brahmin, Kaisto, etc. etc. So, this is the position of Bengal. I have to tell that the what's the reason behind that the Bengal is claiming that too progressive to accept caste. It's a false, not based on facts. But what is the reason behind it? Yes, mindset. It's fact that the pioneers of Bengal Renaissance had no motive to mistreat the people of colonial Bengal. But as Binoy Bose, a well-known sociologist and Sarasdhar, a Marxist retired, wrote that Bengal Renaissance was limited to a radius of 20 kilometers within Calcutta, now Kolkata, as conditions of enlightenment were almost fulfilled in the Europe, as that could not be implemented in colonial India, an aborted form of Renaissance. To position of the midwife to give birth some Bhadra Babur who are within the Bengali literature. One is from within mainstream literature and outside mainstream literature. In the year 1855, Parichat Mitra Ek Chak Thakur wrote in a novel, Alalai Bharadiva, 1855, my teacher's this Alagaya Bhare Dulal, that is a Hindu, who is non-Brahmin, but not quote-unquote lower caste. He practically ridiculed Brahmins. Alagaya Bhare Dulal, the people who are in the stream of the language, they are this Alali method of writing. Neither urban nor rural, neither followed. It's a peculiar Alali form. He ridiculed the Brahmins. He even compared this secret threat of the Brahmins as a rope of the rope of these people who are going in the hand. Mind you, it is a technique. And Alalai Bhare Dulal was a popular novel in that period. Also, Parichat Mitra was a popular writer that was in the mainstream literature world. jumping upon the 1933, Simran Chakur, he is a well-known writer also. In his mainstream literature, they are something different. we can cite if question comes. In the outside mainstream literature, exactly the year I can say, but Ramaya Pandit, he has called Pandit, but he is from lower class. He wrote Sunnapura. Sunnapura means Puran, means the Puran is mythology, Puran means old religious texts, and he just decided. His statement is like that. This Puran entire mythology is zero, is nothing. Maybe 400 years ago. It's a parallel statement. All of us possibly know the name of Lala. Lala is a idol of us in Lala started this parallel literature, where the intent is anti-Vedic and non-Brahminical. After that, this entire literature of undivided Bengal was based on basically anti-Vedic and non-Brahminical. Not only Lalan, the Mudwa, Sayadhani, Kartavaja, all of them. Now, I am coming to the role of the council. In the Indian situation, there is within the counting movement, there are the weakest stream within the communist movement, with effect in Bengal also, reflect. Rajmungsi, peasant woman, the leader of this group was, they were just demonstrating him. Demanding land. Eight of them was women. One is a kid, possibly in the lap of his mother, and two young men. 11 people were marked by this government, led by the officer of Montpellier. Possibly you can assume the place of this non-Bengal is the then become well known to the almost Asian people, the world people also. The place is Nakhalwa, 1926 May. Still Nakhalwa Day is being every 25th May they honor the martyrs. After 77, it's a good majority when the communist official Marxist came in power in Bengal. After that, the very popular floor with them. Though officially they don't declare, but there are statements in that is Dalit writers that a non-Dalit cannot write on Dalit cause. He or he has no right to speak on Dalit cause, act on Dalit cause. Sometimes IMB also, different times IMB also hated by the so-called Dalit lovers, the Dalit activists for my son. So it's not in a surprising thing. You have to pay for that, what my forefathers. Still, it's also sectarian attitudes within the Dalit movement, which hampered definitely Dalit cause. So, Manojin Bakari will write as because they are from Dalit family. Nanantu Ajajjo won't write because he is from which family. Still, I am not Dalit. So we start. The leadership problem is going on, but sorry. As because the Daffodam is too much in this problem, the Daffodam's network worked nicely. Now this magazine has reached next book fair is coming. We have given we've got around the 6,000. And the surprising thing is that most of our readers are from what I call lower caste family, Dalit family, and as well as first generation writer. Most of the our readers read like that. Ami Tapan, Kuno Sakuna, Sudra Sakuna is dying. This is the habit. Even from the aged person, they buy our books are there. We are working together with one of the registered publishing agency, Janoman. We are working together. Janoman is working from last 8 years.
Same and that book fair, he asked me, have you read that too? I said, yes sir, but I published Chandralini Judith in this book fair. I replied that.
Which I'm going to ask him is why he began writing. You can speak in Hindi, and I will translate it.
हमको झेलने के लिए तैयार हो जाइए आप लोग क्योंकि कुछ बात आप सबके खिलाफ भी जा सकता है आज से करीबन 20 साल पहले इसके पहले एक बार हम दिल्ली आए थे 20 साल पहले एक बार आए थे इसी यूनिवर्सिटी में अनिता भारती जी उनका नाम तो आप लोग कई बार सुन चुके हैं उनका एक प्रोग्राम था तो उस समय एक बात हम बताए थे वही बात से आप शुरू करेंगे सबसे पहले एक बात और बता दूं कि आप लोग तो लिखे पढ़े लोग हैं और लिखे पढ़े लोगों को बात पे इतने देर तक सुने हैं लिखे पढ़े लोगों की बात लिखे पढ़े लोग अच्छा समझ सकते हैं लेकिन हम तो अनपढ़ हैं फिर थोड़ी देर के लिए हमारे पास समझना भी थोड़ा दिक्कत आ जाएगा लेकिन मेरा प्रयास रहेगा ताकि आप समझ सकें शब्द से नहीं तो कम से कम दिल से
Difficult to translate, as you can understand, long, lengthy video of Monroe, and try to understand writings and speeches made by educated people. I am largely illiterate, so for some time, listen to me and try to understand what I say. If not through your mind, then maybe through your heart.
Dilli durast. जब कोई काम हमको लगता था कि हम कर डालेंगे और औरों को लगता था कि नहीं हो नहीं पाएगा तो बोलते थे दिल्ली दूरस्थ हमको भी लगा था कि दिल्ली जाना बड़ी मुश्किल की बात है राजधानी है तो फिर 20 साल पहले एक बार हम आ गए थे और समझ लीजिए हम आ ही गए थे अब की बार लेकर के 5 बार हो गया हेबिटेट सेंटर में भी बहुत बड़ा कार्यक्रम हुआ था वहां भी आए थे और अपने बात हम रखे थे और हम तो अब ही रहेंगे हमको आप रोकेगा मैं गाली है कौन जैसे जैसे जो सवाल हमको किया उन्होंने ये सवाल कई बार हो चुका उसका भी जवाब हम वहां दे चुके हैं आप लोग पेपरों में वो तो दैनिक जागरण में भार फरना भर के वो बात आया था तो कोई देख रहे हैं आप क्यों लिखते हैं तो मेरा सीधा सा जवाब था और वही बात आप भी दोहराना चाहूंगा कि मैं मर्डर नहीं कर सकता इसलिए लिखता हूं अगर मैं मर्डर कर सकता तो लिखता नहीं जब तक मैं कर सकता तब तक हमने नहीं लिखा जिस दिन से वो काम हम छूट गया उम्र बढ़ गया जेल जाने का अब हमारा ताकत नहीं है तो फिर हमको लिखना पड़ा
As long as I could kill people, I did not have to take to writing. But now that after I got thrown into the jail and I left that violence, I have taken to writing.
एक आदमी ही रास्ते से जा रहा, उसको प्यास लगा, वो देखा एक कुएं है, बाल्टी भी है, थोड़ा से पानी उठाया, पी लिया बेचारा, तो उसको रड़ी तो बोलते हैं क्या? गर्म करके उसको हाथ जलाया जाता है आपको लगता है कि उस आदमी को मार देना चाहिए हालांकि मैं तो फांसी का खिलाफ धनंजय का जो फांसी हुआ उसको भी मैं विरोध किया लेकिन कभी कभी ऐसा लगता है कि कुछ कुछ लोगों को तो मार देना ही चाहिए एक तीन साल का बच्ची घर में रख करके मां गया किसी घर में बर्तन वाले, उसका टूटा फूटा घर, किसी ने घुस गया घर में और वो बच्ची पर, आप समझ ही सकते हैं हमने क्या बताया, क्या क्या घुसाते हैं उसके शरीर में, आपको लगता है कि उसको मार देना चाहिए। एक आदिवासी इन सभ्यताओं से, इन देश से कुछ नहीं मांगता, कुछ नहीं, हमने छत्तीसगढ़ बहुत दिन तक रहा, वो बोलते हैं ये सभ्यता ये सरकार तुम हमसे थोड़ा दूर रहो हमको जीने दो। उसका व्रत क्या है, मिट्टी का नीचे वो जहाँ बैठे उस मिट्टी का नीचे खनिज पदार्थ है, लोहा तमार यूरेनियम, इसी अवरत से उसको वहां बेदखल किया जा रहा, उसको बहु बेटी पर बलात्कार किया जा रहा, उसको गोली से मारा जा रहा, माओवादी बोलते उसको जेल में चला देना, जो उनको बहुत सारे लोगों को जीना हराम करके रख दिया, उसको कोई रहम नहीं दिखाना चाहिए, अगर रहम दिखाएंगे तो हम लोग नहीं जी सकते। क्या कसूर था हमारा, क्यों जेल में डाल दिया था, हमने क्या मांगा था तुमसे, इतना ही तो मांगा था कि थोड़ा सा खाने दो और तो एक दो पुस्तक दो, हम स्कूल जाना चाहते, लिखाई पढ़े, हम 24 साल में जेल में लिखाई पढ़ी सीखे, 10 पुस्तक हम लिख डाले, बांग्ला एकेडमी पुरस्कार भी मिला, इस साल भी एक उपन्यास है शंकर गोनी, अगर हम बचपन में लिखाई पढ़ी सीख लेते 24 साल की उम्र में उतना तक आते आते हम कितना सीखते और हम इन समाज को साहित्य के माध्यम से कितना कुछ दे सकते। लेकिन हमारा हाथ तो कट्टा क्यों थमा दिया, चाकू क्यों थमा दिया, अपराधी तुम हो हम नहीं, हम इस देश के स्वाधीन देश के नागरिक, आजाद देश के नागरिक, हम रास्ते में एक पैसा भीख मांगेंगे किसी से, 2 रुपये मांगेंगे कि हम भूखा है हमको खाने दो, देगा नहीं, और उसी व्यक्ति का पेट में चाकू हम घुसा देंगे, तिहार जेल हो किसी जेल में ले जाएगा, गर्म खाना मिलेगा, कंबल मिलेगा, रहने के लिए मौका मिलेगा, क्यों हमको उस काम तुम क्यों कराते हो, उसके पहले हमको एक रोटी दो रोटी दे दो ना, तो हम ऐसा तो नहीं करेंगे।
What was used to cut off his hands? This man, I feel, should be murdered. A girl child of 3 years, mother has left her alone and gone for work. Somebody comes into the room, brutalizes her. What? How many different things are pushed into bodies of these girls, these young men, these Dalits? A tribal who wants nothing from his government. The only fault of that tribal is that the soil that he's standing on is mineral rich. They will be tortured, killed as long as they cannot, or as long as they do not give up their land. These are the people whom I want to kill. I cannot kill, so I do it through my literature. This country of ours, here a few have made life hell for so many of us. We must show them no mercy. All that we wanted was food, some education. It is at the age of 24 that I first learned letters when I went to prison. I've written 10 books since then. My last one is on Shambhu Bhuvan Yogi, who was an activist among the tribals. Chhattisgarh, that is where he spent a lot of time. If I had been educated before, if I had been literate before, I could have written so much more, I could have given so much more to society. So you are the criminals against whom I write. I am not the criminal. I was hungry, and for hunger, we ask for bread. You do not give it to us, and therefore we have to take up the knife or the bomb and to kill you. Why do you put this knife or bomb into my hands? The jail turns out to be therefore a good place to us. We are given blankets, we are given food, but why do you have to bring us to this?
Abhi, hum ek desh bhikari, hamare paas koi desh nahi hai. Hum us paar chale jaye the, border cross karke. To wahan humko bola jata hai, ye Hindu hai. ये मालाउन है, ये कापेर है, विदर्भी है, मारो काटो साले को, गाली दे ही दिया। इस पर हम चले जाते हैं, आते हैं शरणार्थी, रिपुजी, उद्वास्तु, वास्तुआरा और अनुप्रवेशकारी, तो हमारा देश कहाँ है, वो बॉर्डर क्यों खींचा, हमसे पूछ के खींचा कि हमको वो बॉर्डर
बेगर्स क्रिमिनल्स। So why did you draw that border? You didn't ask us when drawing that border. You drew that border according to your needs, your benefits and privileges. And we were the victims of that. When we crossed over, 6 years we had to stay in one refugee camp. And after that, the government said they didn't do anything. There was no rehabilitation program which they could put up for us for those 6 years. After that, they told us to go to Dandukaruma. Now, Dandukaruma is a place which my people too know a little bit of, because we also have heard of Ramayana, read the stories of Ramayana, or heard the stories of Ramayana. And we know that Ram was sent for one of us on his exile to the forest, to that place. So we knew it could not be a very good place, and we did not want to go there.
whereupon the government told us that in case, in that case, we are not going to give you anything more, no more dole or anything for you. So many people, thousands of people, we moved to different slums, we set up slums beside the gutters, beside the railway stations. My sister, when she was about 6 years old, in front of my eyes, I saw her starve to death. My father was also on his deathbed. And that is when I left home out of hunger and I moved all around. I went to the north of Bengal, which is the place where the Naxalbari village is. And that is when I first heard of the Naxal movement. I used to wash dishes in a small tea shop, which was near the court. And I would see these Adivasi convicts being tied and had been handcuffed or whatever and being taken to the court. And somehow I would feel that they and I, we were on the same side. And he says a tea shop like the university, like a prison, is a place where you get to acquire a lot of knowledge. There are a lot of narratives and discourses going on there. There is a lot of knowledge which you can gather from these places. A tea shop is also like that. So I heard a lot about this new revolution, this new ideology of the Naxalites, which was coming in at this time. And I grew firm in my belief that both they and me, we were victims of the problem of hunger. So then after that I came to Calcutta, and then I found that there were these Naxal slogans written, scrawled on all the walls. Now, in Calcutta we lived a little separate, not near the Bhadradok, not near the middle class, because my mother would work in their house to wash utensils, etc. So we would live a little separate in a kind of a corner. And there I, because I was as hot-headed as he says, you can see me, and I talk a lot, I am not very tame, so to say. So there too, I told my friends a lot of tall tales about what I had seen in North Bengal, and I made up a lot of stories about how I had seen bombs being thrown and shooting going on and the Naxals being so great. And I described the leader of the Naxalite movement, Kalu Shainal, completely imaginary portrait, as a very tall, muscular man, big moonch, and really great. And he says, later when I really saw Kalu Shainal, I was completely flabbergasted because he was nothing like that, of course. But I made up all these tall tales, and the friend I told it to got very inspired. And on the wall, there is this, they write in the corner whom the wall belongs to. So it's sort of laying claim to the wall. So it was written CPN. Now who was completely fired with the Naxalite ideology. And therefore, the leader of the Calcutta Naxalite movement, Ashu Mujumdar, called for this young firebrand to be brought to him. And they offered him treatment, etc., because he was of their group.
गरीबों के लिए लड़ाई किया, उनको जान भी जा सकता था, वो खोकर मजूमदार है, बहुत बड़ा साहित्यिक शिष्य मुखर्जी है, मौसदे भी कहला का नवरण भट्टज है, बहुत बड़ा वामपंथी तात्विक नेता अशोक
मित्रा
जी है, ऐसे कितने नाम हम ले सकते हैं जिन्होंने जिनका लेख में चूड़ी चमारी इस शब्द का इस्तेमाल किया हमारे एक दलित लेखक है नाम नहीं बताऊंगा उन्होंने भी इस शब्द का इस्तेमाल किया चूड़ी चमारी अभी ये जो ब्राह्मणवादी चिंताधारा हमारे अंदर घुसपैठ करके बैठा है हम इसको पहचान नहीं सकते चूड़ी ये तो बहुत खराब चीज है सब कोई जानता है चमारी कैसे खराब हुआ भाई चमार तो एक मेहनती आदमी है उनके ऊपर में एक ऐसा रोक दिया কাউরার মতো কথা বলিস না যে কাউরা যে সব বাতচিত মত কর ও থোড়া আওয়াজ থোড়া জোর সে বাত করতে হ্যাঁ তো উসকো ও যে থোড়া জোর সে বাত করেগা উসকো উসি জাতি ও এক অবগুণ মানা জাতা হ্যায় ই হ্যায় জো কি কবি কবি হাম ভি শায়দ হামারে লোগ ভি বোল দেতা হুঁ ই অবচেতন মে হামারে অন্দর ভি ইয়ে ব্রাহ্মণবাদী চিন্তা ভাবনা ঘুসপেট করকে বৈঠা হ্যায় ইসসে হাম নিকল নাহি পাতে তো ও জো वामपंथी कुछ लोग हैं उसके अंदर भी ये चीज घुसा है अब हम 10 पार्टी कार्यकर्ता एक जगह उसमें तो हम उतने जानते नहीं पढ़ाई लिखाई के वो भी हो सकता है उनका सोच में जहां हर कोई बैठा है सुन रहा सीख रहा कुछ वहां हमको जाने का कोई जरूरत नहीं तू क्या तू तो पढ़ाई लिखा हम लोग सुन लेते हैं फिर बाद में मैंने हमको वहां जाने वो लोग देते ही नहीं ये सब चीज जब हमको थोड़ा थोड़ा मन में आया फिर हमने जब देखा जो कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी का सीपीआई वाले को देखा सीपीएम वाले को देखा नक्सल को भी देखा कि ये जो इनका जो उच्च स्तरीय जो लीडरशिप है उनमें हमारे नमसुद तो कोई नहीं है, दलित कावरा कोई नहीं, बागदी कोई नहीं, मुसलमान एक आज होंगे लेकिन उतना नहीं है। क्यों? अभी आप लोग तो सब हिंदी क्षेत्र से है तो ये कहानी तो आप सब पढ़ ही चुके हैं, हम तो बताना लेकिन थोड़ा याद दिलाने के लिए कि प्रेमचंद मुंशी जी की कहानी है। ऐसे ही है शायद कि चार बच्चे एक जगह एक स्कूल में खेलते हैं और मास्टर जो है बोलते हैं कि है देखो कोई जात पात नहीं है हमारे, ये तो कोई तो ये थोड़ा थोड़ा हमको दिमाग में आने लगा लेकिन उतना नहीं आया था। हाँ सब समझाते थे कि क्रांति हो जाएगा तो उसके बाद में तो सब तो अब अम्बेडकर बात जो है इस बारे में हमारे बंगाल में उतना खास चर्चा तो था नहीं, ज्यादातर लोग यही बोलते थे अम्बेडकर जी ने संविधान रचना किया बस उतना है, इससे ज्यादा और कुछ नहीं, वो एक उनका अहंकार था। लेकिन हम कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी के साथ जुड़े रहने की कारण ये जो राष्ट्र व्यवस्था है ये जो संविधान है इसके प्रति हमारा तो श्रद्धा तो था नहीं, हम तो इस संविधान को इस तरह मानते थे, मानते भी है आज भी कि ये शोषण व्यवस्था जो है ये कायम रखने के लिए वो उनका हाथ में एक हथियार है। जो भी व्यवस्था लागू किया गया वो तो संविधान से ही तो दिखाया गया कि ये लागू किया जा सकता, संविधान में इस प्रावधान है। मणिपुर में अभी जो मिलिट्री मार्च किया जा रहा वो भी तो संविधान में प्रावधान तो है कि नहीं? लेकिन वहाँ जो आप भी जानते हैं हम भी जानते हैं कितना अन्याय वहाँ हो रहा, अभी छत्तीसगढ़ में जो मिलिट्री मिलिट्री में वो तो सिपाही पुलिस जो उतना ज़्यादा पुस्तक हम नहीं पढ़े लेकिन हमको ऐसा लगा। हाँ ये भी बात हमें सिपाही को बताए और एक भी बात भी यार सोचा था जैसे एक रेल लाइन है उस बाजू में नक्सल लाइन इस बाजू में सिपाही उस तरफ से हम लोग बम बम जो भी लेके इधर आ गए इधर के लोग जो है इलाका को दखल करना है तो ये रेल बस्ती का जो लोग है वो हमको हम उस पर तो कोई आक्रमण कर ही नहीं पा रहा, उसको तो छो नहीं पा रहा। रुनुगु नियोगी बंगाल का सबसे बड़ा पुलिस है, उस समय इतना अत्याचार किया जैसे वो अंग्रेज का समय में जैसे वो था क्या टेगा उसी तरह था, उस तरह तो उतना तक तो पहुंच नहीं पा रहा है, मर रहा है तो कोई होमगार्ड कोई पुलिस वाला ट्रैफिक पुलिस वाला तो वो भी एक दिल में दुख है तो हम बोला नहीं अब ये लड़ाई हमारा लड़ाई नहीं है सर अब भागना चाहिए। रेलवे स्टेशन में रहना और रेलवे स्टेशन रिक्शा विक्शा चलाना और इस तरह की जिंदगी जो होता है दारू वारू पियो मारपीट मारपीट करो, लेकिन वो थोड़ा बहुत नक्सलाइट लोगों के साथ मिला था तो गरीबों का ऊपर में कहीं पर कोई अन्याय अत्याचार होता था तो हम उसको विरोध में खड़ा हो जाते थे, हमारे साथ कुछ 10-15 लड़का भी छूट गया था तो पुलिस हमको समाज विरोधी करने लगे, मतलब लोग जो है वो हमको समाज विरोधी करने लगे। और
15 minutes. So he says about he was speaking about coming into the Naxalite movement, and he says that there were two kinds of Naxals. One was the urban educated conscious Naxals, and he said that I will not say anything tarnish their the image that they have of patriotism, because they believe that they were patriotic. They did truly, genuinely have love for the poor, for the downtrodden, and they tried to help us. But this casteism, he says, is something which we don't realize. It sits quietly within us, and possibly this was the case with these Naxalite, well-meaning people also. He named some more, I could take down only three writers belonging to the upper caste who have written on the exploitation and the brutality perpetrated on the lower castes or the poor, Mahashita Devi, Ashok Mitra, Manik Bandyopadhyay. And he said that in all these people have always been writing for us then. But subconsciously, casteism is part of their minds also. He gives examples of certain phrases which they use. The phrase churi chamar. Churi is thieving, and chamar is a person who lives by skinning dead animals. So he says they use the phrase churi chamar almost without meaning anything. Meaning thieving,
But why are you criminalizing the activity of the chamar? If you want to say somebody is a thief, somebody is a thief. But why are you adding the word chamari to that? Because the chamari is an honest laboring person. So in this way, this kind of words that he uses, he says this other word, that don't talk like a kaura, meaning if you raise your voice and are too belligerent, you are branded as belonging to one of the lower castes, the kaaris. As furious as the chandal, as if only the chandal can have that kind of fury, destructive fury. So he says in this way, through the language and the system, casteism has entered our blood and we are often not aware of what we are saying. Then he says that this was also present within the leftists, within the Naxalites themselves. Maybe they also thought that I was uneducated and so I was different from them, because there would often be classes which they would hold and I was not expected to be part of the classes. So they would say, you don't need to be there, you can finish this other work and we'll listen, we'll understand and then we'll tell you, don't worry. So whenever there was any kind of work which was laboring work, like making chapatis or washing the utensils, etc., that always somehow fell on me. We did meetings and processions and we came back, but and then they said, well, they did something else, more cerebral, intellectual, I was given these jobs. And he cites a story from Premchand, and he says Premchand has a story about four young boys playing, and the person is saying that, look, there is so much of enmity between the castes, because we have Brahmins, Chandals, this, that, etc., Nakshatra, whatever. But the writer is saying that they were playing horse-horse, you know. One becomes a horse and the other is like a man. And whenever it came to being a horse, that horse was always from the Dalit boy. So he says, in this way, in spite of the sympathy and the love which I got with as being when being part of the Naxalite movement, I was always made the horse. And therefore I realized, I noticed that there were no leaders among the Naxalites from our community. In Bengal, he says, Ambedkar's teachings are not as deeply or as well known. And being part of the communist movement, the leftist, the Naxalite movement also, it is not that I had much respect for the constitution, because I believed and I could see that the constitution was something which had been created by the privileged, by the upper caste, and it could be used as an instrument against the poor and the downtrodden. So he says that this was one kind of the urban educated Naxals, and the other kind was my kind of Naxals, who were also part of the Naxal movement. And that came home to me when one day we were, or not one day, I mean, when we would line up on two sides of the railway line, the two platforms. The people like, he cites the name Runu Guhunyo, who was a terror of a police officer and who suppressed successfully the Naxalite rebellion of the 70s. He said, these people could we could never touch. So we were never killing those people. We were killing ourselves. So they killed one of his friends, Kartik, a poor boy like him. And that struck a lot of sorrow into his heart. But he says, what do we do when something like that happens? We go and kill one of them. But what the bottom line is that we end up killing our own people. So this is something which came home to me through the politics which I got involved in. Then he said that my family began inquiring about me, where was I, and they were told that when he's just about.
Jail, chalenge. लेकिन जेल हमारा पास जेल नहीं था, वो विश्वविद्यालय था। हमने जब जेल में घुसा तो बहुत रो रहा था, तो साढ़े पांच फुट ऊपर में खिड़की है, वहां एक आदमी बैठा था, करीबन 60 साल उम्र का, वो बाहर खिड़की से बाहर तक झांक रहा था। तो हम गुस्से पर हमको देखा, हम रो रहे हैं, तो क्या तो रो रहा है जेल में, कौन सा केस? पता नहीं, पुलिस बोला था सर हमारे जेल में रहना पड़े। हम बोला इधर आ, देख तो खिड़की से कुछ दिखाई दे रहा। हम कान से झाका सर जेल, उसके बाद में मेन रोड, उसके बाद में नेशनल लाइन, तो दिख तो नहीं पा रहा। बोला अच्छा से देख, ये तो मैंने दिखने वाले जो निगाह है, ये जो कितना बड़ा भाई, कोई यार कितना चीज जो हम लोग हमारे सामने से गुजर जाता हम देख नहीं पाते, लेकिन उसमें भी बहुत कुछ है जो देख जाए वो देख जाते हैं। खिड़की में एक छोटा सा बाढ़ का पेड़ दिख रहा, बोला अब तो दिख रहा, वो दिखाया, बोलो वहां तो पानी नहीं है, मिट्टी नहीं है, कुछ नहीं, वो कैसे जिंदा है? तो जीना चाहते हैं वो कहीं पर भी जी जाता है, जीने का जो इच्छा वो होना चाहिए, उसलिए वो बड़ पर जी रहा। और कुछ दिन बाद में वो दीवार जो तोड़ डालेगा वो बड़ा हो जाएगा। हमने इससे बड़ा और उसी से हमने शिक्षा लिया और उसी से मैं जिंदा हूँ कि मैं मरना नहीं चाहता मरूंगा नहीं मिला उसको थोड़ा आप बता सकते हैं क्या हमने कहा जी जी मिशा ये शब्द का अर्थ क्या है उन्होंने कहा पीछे थका इच्छा और पाची वाली इच्छा जीने का तमन्ना फिर उन्होंने कहा कि तुम तो ये शब्द को तुमको मिला कहाँ से हमने कहा एक पुस्तक से कितना तुम पढ़ाई लिखाई हमने कहा कुछ पढ़ाई लिखाई नहीं तब उन्होंने कहा कि तुम्हारे जैसे कम लिखे पढ़े लोग हमारे पत्रिका निकालता है उसमें लिखता है तुम लिखोगे अच्छा वो था महाशय देवी है तब हमने कहा ठीक है आप तो अभी तक तो कभी लिखा नहीं प्रयास करूंगा अगर हो सकता है तो एक लेख हमने लिखा था परीक्षा चल रही उसका नाम था वो छप गया था पत्रिका में और जब पत्रिका में छप गया था तो देखा कि कुछ लोग ढूंढ ढूंढ के आपसे मिलने को आ रहा है उस लिख में कुछ शायद था ये व्यक्ति जो है हमारे बाजू में बैठा है उस पुस्तक का उस लेख पढ़ के 25 साल तक हमको ढूंढता रहा कहाँ कहाँ गए ढूंढे छत्तीसगढ़ तक जंगल में चले गए हमको वो एक लेख इनको ऐसा किया फिर 25 साल बाद मिले दोस्त बन गए अभी इनका पत्रिका बन गया ये मैं लिखता हूँ तो उसके बाद से जब लोग मिलने लगे और लोग फरमाइश करने लगे भाई अच्छा तुम जेल गए थे तो जेल के बारे में इतना से इतना तो बता दो अच्छा तुम रिफ्यूजी है शरणार्थी उस पर से तो जेल की वहां से इतना तब हम लिखने लगे छापने लगे लोगों को निगाह थोड़ा बदलने लगे अब पहले जब लोग आते थे रिक्शा जमीन गिरे आप थोड़ा देखे थोड़ा जो पहचानते हैं थोड़े इज्जत से बात करते हैं उतना ये करते नहीं तो थोड़ा अच्छा लिखने से इतना बड़ा मजा यहाँ भी बैठा हूँ आपके सामने यहाँ मजा हमारा कि आपके सामने कुर्सी में बैठूँ आप कहाँ और हम कहाँ अभी भी एक स्कूल में मैं खाना पकाने वाला काम करता हूँ एक मजे की बात वो लोग आ गए बड़े बड़े 24 परगना का बड़े बड़े नेता लोग और हम चाय बना के ट्रे में लेके उनके वहाँ गए आप वो देखा तो हमको चौंक गया लुंगी उंगी पहन के चाय तो जो बड़े सबसे बड़ा नेता था उत्तम पर बोले ये कैसे आपसे चाय पिए हम बोले देखो ये जगह जो है तुम्हारा है तुम यहाँ मालिक हो हम तुम्हारे नौकर हैं ये हम तुमको चाय पिलाएंगे और जब हम मंच पर ले जाओगे तो तुम हमको माला वाला दोगे तो फिर अब लिख रहा हूँ लिखते लिखते 10-12 पुस्तक हो गया दो दो बड़ा बड़ा पुरस्कार भी मिला बांग्ला ऐसे ही मिला 24 घंटा उन्होंने मिला छोटा छोटा और भी 2-4-10 मिला और सबसे ज्यादा 20,000 प्रतियां ये बिक्री हो चुका इन्हीं के हिसाब से और आप जैसे कुछ लोग हमको मिला मित्र बोलिए मित्र और हमारे प्रति आपका हमदर्दी है तो वो भी है जो भी है आप जैसे कुछ लोग मिला ये मेरा सबसे बड़ा लेखक जीवन का प्राप्ति इसको मैं
I'm going to ask for something rather unfair. Hindi, you could not understand this Hindi. Is only Judith and Nicole?
Yeah.
Can I translate what he said for you?
Yeah.
I have one more question which I just need to ask him.
Yeah. But later you can translate.
No, I'll translate it to them in detail. One question for him, one for him. So did the Marxist movement fail in Bengal? It's for all of the Acharya. And for him, what do you want to be known as? Monoranjan Dapari, the Dalit writer, or what? Monoranjan, what do you want to be known as? What do you want to be known as? What do you want to be known as? Okay, then Monoranjan has asked a question about the Marxist movement in Bengal.
I should say that not fail, it's a Sephardic setback. Supposing there is a difference between failure and setback. Not in Bengal, not only in India, in the world. The different reasons for this setback. If we stay on the Bengal coast, the Dalit movement will again come. My personal experience and as well as the organizational experience, I can say that the before the last 25 years, I was writing as a obsessed Marxist. So that didn't work properly. After that, I read, before reading Jyotiba Phule, Periyar or Ambedkar, the book which helped us a very lot, the D.D. Kosambi, An Introduction to the Study of Indian History. It's a Bengali translation also here. That book taught us like that is, there is in Indian society the peculiarity of the obvious, uniqueness of Indian society is that the difference or distance between class and caste will be small. So it changed our mindset. And after that, we started reading Ambedkar, Periyar, Phule, initially Phule. Phule and Periyar was, if we choose. And after that, we realized, but it's not I realized that as an Indologist, Marx was not a successful person. So, then we had to rethink on caste question. So, after Kosambi, we wrote Rahul's mainly the new book, the very good Communism. We read Devipusha Chattopadhyay, which is like on atheism in India. Ramakrishna Bhattacharya is on Charva. It really inspired us to be with this caste question activity at Animalism. Then we decided that the activists were serious about to annihilate the caste, and the activists who were working for abolition of class, or both of them, who are willing to build a society free from discrimination based on class, gender, and religion, should come together, should unite. So we started like that. And what is the methodology? Two people writings help us much. One is Paulo Freire, Pedagogy of the Oppressed. These books help us a lot. As because we have already made a base reading Periyar, Phule, Ambedkar, Jogendranath Mandal, Harichand Gurucha. Then how to be in the practice process? Paulo helped us a lot, Pedagogy of the Oppressed. And please don't miss that. We got a report from China, they most of them are these without acknowledgement of Mao, but though they follow these Paulo Freire's method, Pedagogy of the Oppressed, as well as the 500 words club or 1000 words club. So that is why at least at present, we do not think that the Marxism has failed. We suffered a lot. And Marxist in India, not member of Marxist in India, they didn't want. They should rethink, they should see that they should be self-critical, they should be revise their position, revise their method of what is method of thinking.
मिलने वाला है और वो मैं लेकर जाऊंगा वो बाबा साहब अम्बेडकर का नाम का जो पुरस्कार एक है उसको मैं तो उसको लेकर लड़ूंगा वो आपको मिल चुका है
मैं
वो तो आप लोग तो उसे भी बहुत बड़ा पुरस्कार दे चुके हैं बहुत बड़ा पुरस्कार एक रिक्शा वाले जो कभी स्कूल में आया नहीं और 20,000 प्रति है उसको कितना पुना है और कितने अभी देखिए मेरे पाठक है अभी इसको हम अभी शिखर ने चार दिन पहले आया ये खरीद के देख लिया एक एक आया 70,000 रुपये देखे गए दो महीना पहले ये पुस्तक को पढ़कर वो बॉम्बे से चलाया हवाई जहाज पकड़ के मेरे को मिलने के लिए सत्र जब ये लैपटॉप भी हमारे पास आया हम कहीं ये कनाडा से ₹3300 उन्होंने कनाडा से भेजा ये फल ये जो लोगों का दिल तो छुआ है इस पुस्तक उसी का मैंने दिल में हम जिंदा रहेंगे और वो मैंने सबसे मेरे लेख में कुछ जहर रहता है अभी 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 दादाजी ने कोई दादाजी ने अभी बेबी हल्दर का नाम बताया कि किसने बताया वो बेबी हल्दर के साथ जिन जिन लोगों का परिचय है मेरा भी वही लोगों के साथ ही परिचय था संजय जुने कचरापारा रोशनी पोकाजनी जो छापा जो कहा कि ये गरीब को इतना मत सताओ इतना मत भूखा रखो नहीं तो वो तुम्हारा सुख चैन छीन लेगा वो गैन जो को उसी को कुट करके हम पूरा लिख जाए उस पर चला दी आप ही अलमलाई चौधरी के पास हो जब लेख गया तो देखा है हम सगे तंग अब गालिया जाता है क्या करें भाषा विषय कि इसको हम पैसा देंगे हमारे तनखा में हमारे पेपर में ये पूंजीपति के खिलाफ ऐसे ही खाली बकता रहेगा फिर वो ना फिर हम वो हमारे पास और दोस्त में लेकर अच्छा फिर हम बोला क्या हमारे कैसे इतना लेट बहुत अच्छा था साहब को भेजा लेट बहुत अच्छा था लेकिन आप इसको हम लोग छाप नहीं सकते तो लेट नहीं छापा फिर हमसे कोई संपर्क भी नहीं रखा तो बात यही है हमारे साथ आप लोग में से कोई अगर लेना चाहे दो चार पुस्तक आप लोग के लिए लेके आया है ज्यादा तो नहीं आप लोग लेना चाहें पुस्तक है तो आप लोग ले सकते हैं दो चार पुस्तक है छह लाए थे दो बीच में चार